But first tonight, SpaceX is going back to the drawing board after it watched its Starship blow up in the sky during a test flight this morning.
It lifted off from Texas, but just could not make it to orbit. Within minutes, the rocket was gone. Westry Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler joins us live tonight. And Scott, even though the rocket exploded, some are calling this a success.
Yes, and actually maybe an appropriate term is a successful failure. That's because it takes a lot of testing and data to get the world's largest rocket off the pad and that same craft that will ultimately bring humans back to the lunar surface. It was just a few minutes after liftoff at 9:33 in the morning when the Super Heavy booster rocket was supposed to separate from Starship.
As of right now, we are awaiting stage separation.
That did not happen, and the 390-foot tall integrated rocket stack began corkscrewing before exploding just under 4 minutes after launching Thursday from Starbase in South Texas.
Starship just experienced what we call a rapid, unscheduled disassembly.
Now, even in its failure, it was majestic and spectacular to watch. But, you know, the key thing is they didn't want it to fail on the pad because then you got to replace the pad, and that's a lot of money.
While the rocket only reached about 24 miles, SpaceX emphasizing before and after the launch that simply getting it off the ground would be seen as a success. It reached max Q when the rocket experienced the maximum aerodynamic pressure, an important milestone. But the critical stage separation failure caused the test to end short.
The biggest problems are always in the interfaces, and where things come together is usually where you'll find a problem.
The plan was to get Starship into a partial orbit up at about 145 miles before belly flopping in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii after a 90-minute flight. Now the SpaceX engineers will pore through the data gleaned from those nearly 4 minutes of flight and see what needs to be done for the next test launch.
SpaceX has a relatively unique a mindset about just trying things out and not being afraid to blow things up. I think you see with a lot of the newer rocket companies, actually, and especially in initial tests, saying we really have low expectations.
Head of SpaceX Elon Musk tweeting out his congratulations to the team and that they're going to pour through all that data before they can do that next test launch. And that's expected in the next few months. Reporting live on the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.